Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Origin and Evolution of Life, and in that we are studying topic Cro-Magnon Man. Now, hello students, today we are studying chapter Origin and Evolution of Life, and in that we are studying topic Cro-Magnon Man. Now if I say Cro-Magnon Man, the simple definition of this is Homo sapiens fossils, something which is similar to Homo sapiens but has little differences. So let's study and find out today what are these differences. Cro-Magnon Man. Now if I say about Cro-Magnon Man, yes, they were very close to your Homo sapiens or the human beings which today we are, but there are little differences. For example, Cro-Magnon Man were good hunters. They built their own houses. They preferred more carnivorous diet. Carnivorous diet was available, but they did not prefer it. They could make sophisticated tools with them. Also, tools like spears, arrowheads were very common to those. And they could make fine grinding stone weapons with the use of different kinds of stones which were available at that time. Okay, did they know how to light fire? No, they did not. Did they live in groups? No, they never lived in groups. They never knew the meaning of community, brotherhood. It was only Homo sapiens sapiens that could do all of that. Cro-Magnon Man. Now if I talk about Cro-Magnon Man, they were also called as Homo sapiens fossils. Now Homo sapiens fossils, we could say that they had some similarity with Homo sapiens sapiens, but there were few distinguished characteristics which they also possessed. Now the similar characteristics which we can talk about is they had tall stature. They had about 1.8 meters in height. Also, they possessed erect postures. Now, this erect postures while walking, standing or running was due to the presence of their broad basin or broad lower back. Also, due to the lumbar curvature, or you simply say the spinal curvature or the spinal cord position in them. Now the spinal cord position today which we have is S-shaped. At that time also the spinal cord was S-shaped and it was not erect in that particular order. Now their cranial capacity or the place where the brain was situated was about quite greater as compared to the Netherland man's or the apes. Now, if you observe in Cro-Magnon man, their body structures consist of very prominent and broad chin with their nose slightly raised or elevated, which were narrower, especially in the female counterpart. They were people who lived in caves, or they could be simply called as cave dwellers. They were obviously good hunters and preferred most of the time carnivorous food. Now, for hunting, they were able to make simple tools like spears and arrowheads using some kind of wood and stone. These tools were quite sophisticated and not complex as the other tools which Homo sapiens could make. In them, the dead were always buried according to their customs and traditions, depending upon which custom and tradition that individual belonged. So students, in this part of the chapter, what we did study was about Cro-Magnon man and its various features. I hope students, we are very clear about this concept. Thank you.